Greetings, and welcome to an epilepsy warning. This is the RPG Chick, and welcome to Let's Play Midnight Scenes. Horror themes, blood and gore, racism, homophobia, bullying, and animal cruelty. Be warned. Midnight Scenes from the Woods features an auto-save system. Notification on screen, blah, blah, blah. So this is the last game I'm playing for my little Halloween celebration thing. Playing this completely blind, the only reason you see continue is because, well, I watched a few television channels and was just testing the sound versus my voice, and I think I've got it at the right level. The only options are music and sound effects volume, so I've lessened that a little bit. And just want to thank Patreon supporters Jack Kulk, if I'm pronouncing that right. If not, I apologize. Sophie is a Ghost, Amy Flory, and Herman Hillman. Thank you so much for the support. If anyone would like to support me through Patreon, the link is in the description for that, as well as I've got a donate through PayPal and a Ko-fi account, and I've also got a super thanks thing, which you can send me money, I guess, through comments. I'm not sure how that works. That's through YouTube. But anyway, not necessary, completely optional. I appreciate you watching. And yeah, this is a series of games. I've played the first three, I believe there were, Night Scenes, and then there was a part two, and then it was The Nanny, which is the longest one. It was like a two-part episode. This one may be the longest out of all of them. It says 60 to 90 minutes, I believe it says, for, you know, that's how long it would take you to play. So because I'm reading everything, it's going to take me longer, so it's probably going to take me about 2 hours. That's my prediction. Anyway, so I read all the things. I'm going to be reading completely through this game, so if anyone doesn't want to hear me read completely through this game, well, sorry. Mute it. I don't know. Okay. New game. The Eye. The Eye of Agamotto stares at you and blinks. Elijah, 18 years old, his life will change forever with the arrival of a new patient at Fernwood Creek Center. Turn off the lights and enjoy this chilling tale. Welcome to another dimension. Welcome to Midnight Scenes. Midnight Scenes dimension. The mother lion keeps her cubs in the den for their protection while she patrols the area. She'll confront any animal she deems a threat to her offspring, often fiercely and risking her own life if it comes to it. Can't turn it off. Alright, channel 1. Port Susan News, 8:15 a.m. According to the latest information from the police, a neighbor found the missing boy early in the evening. A decade of uncertainty and pain ends with Oliver back in his parents' arms. We are really pleased to have found the boy safe and sound. It gives us hope we'll find his sister Tina alive too. Kidnapped kids, brother found. Oliver and his older sister Tina were kidnapped and dragged into the woods at night while their parents were away. Okay, so we've got Oliver Darnell, Tina Darnell, and Veronica Turner. Their babysitter was also taken to the forest and brutally murdered. I guess that's her. She probably tried to resist. Both children have been missing for nearly 10 years.
Wow.
And Darnell, Oliver's mother. All we want now is to find Tina so we can be a whole family again. Rescue in the forest, 18 years old, found. I'm loving the, oh, that's great. Yeah, I'm loving the news themes. According to medical sources, the boy is weak but in stable condition. A family spokesperson told the press that Oliver will be transferred to a psychiatric center for young people after his recovery. We hope to make his transition back to the real world much easier this way, the spokesperson said. In other news... Fernwood Creek Mental Health Center for the Youth. Well, Al says, "Tell me, Elijah, how are you doing? We're all devastated by what happened yesterday. It's horrible." Oh, the hell? What were the things hanging off her face? I hope the police finds the answers we're all looking for. But meanwhile, I'm very concerned about how this may be affecting our patients' emotional states. Tell me, have you been able to sleep? Are you having any difficulty controlling your anxiety? Elijah says, "Why don't you cut to the chase and ask me what you really want to know?" What do you mean? I mean Oliver, of course. You want to know if he had anything to do with what happened. Al says, "What? That's not what I'm asking." I must admit, though, that I'm worried about him. I want to make sure he receives the care he needs, but he won't talk to me yet. You're the only one he communicates to, so I could use some help with that. What do you want to know? Why don't you tell me about your relationship with him? There's not much to tell, really. You might remember he arrived during one of our sessions. At first I didn't know anything about who he was or what had happened to him. One week earlier. He's a pro at that wheeling chair there. The new boy is here, Al says. Elijah says, another forgotten soul with a family too busy to care for him. Tell me, how does this new arrival make you feel? I don't like change. I don't know. I don't like change. He might be even worse than the others. Al says, there are plenty of nice people here. I know some of the kids here can be difficult. Is there something specific I should know? Nah, everything is perfect and rosy. Excuse me. Yes? Sure, no problem. I'll be there right away. Come with me to Dr. Green's office. We're going to meet your new mate. I can't contain my excitement. We can look at stuff. Title. Degree in psychiatry from the University of Barcelona. Where the hell is that? Spain. Also talking about some other Barcelona. This thing contains our deepest secrets. It needs to be destroyed. He wants to break the computer. That's a fancy car. Another rich kid, apparently. Al has a peculiar taste. It's a beautiful day outside. Inside, though. Well, I can't look at it. All right. Mental health declaration. They don't fool me. No therapist here has ever read this declaration. Infirmary. Not now. Al is waiting for me in Dr. Green's office. Ads panel. Same old inspirational quotes bullshit. It's Tom. Tom Crawford, 17 years old. His blonde hair shone like the sun, but everyone who touched it was condemned to eternal darkness. Really? I just want to see if there's like alternate text or something. The gym? Nope, not now. Good morning, R2-D2. Classroom? She says not now. Nurse Peter and Nurse Martin. Peter told Martin, "Every night my mother tucks me into bed and kisses me on the cheek. Weird thing is, she died last year." I can see the garden fountain from here. It's kind of inspiring. No, Dr. Green's office. It's 10 o'clock. Tap dancing classes? Intriguing. Leo and John. And then Leo told John, "This morning I found a picture on my phone of me in bed, but I live alone." Damn, look at it. So he's supposed to be going to Dr. Green's office. Main door. It's a cold winter afternoon in 1879. One of the nurses at the children's hospital lets three of her little patients out to play in the snow. A medical emergency troubles her so much she completely forgets about them. Another nurse locks all the doors and windows in anticipation of the oncoming snowstorm. The next morning, they find the corpses of the three children they died embracing, huddled on the other side of the door. You just make that up and that really happened. The noise of the storm drowned out their cries and screams. Damn. Yeah, same thing. Nurse Thaddeus. Thaddeus was a heavy sleeper until he discovered his daughter's ghost staring at him through the window. Really? Father Michael, the founder of this place, posing with his prisoners. Mailboxes. I don't think they delivered the mail yet. Miss Murphy is a goose. I was saying it's like ghosts or something. Good morning, Miss Murphy. It's all Miss Murphy. to the garden. Not now. Ella's waiting for me in Dr. Green's office. Jesse and Nurse Liam. Liam was shaken, and just when I went to turn on the light, I felt there was a hand already on the switch. I think we're all haunted. Cafeteria. I'd give my left hand for a large coffee, though. Can we go to the dorms? Nope. Okay. To the office we go. Still 10 o'clock? Yep. Dr. Eleanor Green, principal. It's here. It's here? I mean, this is the place, not the person calling it, right? Dr. Green says, oh, here you are. Mr. and Mrs. Darnell, Oliver, this is Al Henderson. He'll supervise Oliver's therapy. Al is one of the best psychiatrists in the state. Al says, oh, please sit down. It's a pleasure to meet you. Dr. Green says, and looks like Elijah, our little Stephen King, is also joining us. He's always carrying his notebook around, writing short horror stories. I don't think his stay here inspires him. The garden kind of inspired him, or the fountain or something. Really? He's writing stories, but he calls them sketches, though? They're just sketches, nothing serious. I guess he illustrates them as well. They're just sketches of stories, you know. Al says, come on, don't be modest. I read a couple of your tales, and I couldn't sleep that night. Dr. Green says, I hope you don't mind me taking a picture of your son. It's a little tradition we have with newcomers. It symbolizes the start of their recovery. Elijah, do you mind? My pleasure. This camera is amazing. Not like the shitty ones we use in the photography workshop. Haha, Elijah and his sharp wit. No, he's telling the truth. That's loud. I need to send to Oliver in the frame. Say gouda.
Uh-huh.
What do you say? Did he say gouda? Doesn't sound like it. Perfect. We'll leave you a copy in your mailbox in a few days, Oliver. And now, are you ready to discover your new home? Elijah, sweetheart, why don't you give Oliver a tour around the premises while we finish the paperwork? Oh. Oliver's mother says, everything will be fine, my dear. In a few weeks, you'll feel much better and finally come home. We love you, son, his father says. Elijah says, I could tell that Oliver was kind of different right away. What do you mean? Says Al. He didn't say a word. He just observed his surroundings very carefully. I also found him fidgety. In any case, I took my tour guide duty very seriously, and I praised the center every chance I got. Hi. As you heard, my name's Elijah, and I'm going to be one of your mates here. Come on, follow me. Welcome to Fernwood Creek Mental Health Center for the Youth. Yada, yada, yada. As you can see, it's one of those old school boys-only places. To be honest, it's not that bad. This place isn't that bad. Just stay away from the bullies and you'll be mostly fine. I've been here a couple months, courtesy of a panic disorder that's getting uglier each passing day. What about you? Why are they locking you up here? Here's an answer. Okay, don't worry. You don't have to answer if you don't want. Come on, I'll show you where everything is. Yuck. This window could use cleaning. They say the passage of time is inescapable, but here it slows to a crawl. I can only go back from here. Okay. You'll find all the information about mandatory activities here. If you're like me, you'd rather stay in a bed than attending, but they won't let you. Joe Mama. Joe Mighty Fingers Gonzalez will retire in a month. This place will crumble to dust without him. Oh, great. Father Michael, the founder of this place posing with his prisoners. Oh, yeah, I read that already. They'll put your mail in here, after some scrutiny from the supervisors, of course. This is Ms. Murphy, our mascot. Fancy centers have meadows with horses. Here we have a stupid goose. Oh! Go back to your forest, Mowgli. Really? Found a bully? Yeah, run, you idiots. You'll get used to it. Shall we continue the tour? Oh, I wanted to look in the other rooms, though. Then I showed Oliver around the garden. Everyone was giving him suspicious looks. At the time, I didn't know his face was in the news. All this nonsense about Oliver and his connection to what's been going on, it spread since minute one. The garden is my favorite place. I can sit alone here and write for hours. Oliver? Where is he going now? Well, let's go back inside then. Enter the center. I better go find Oliver. Nurse Mark? Mark was an overthinker. His skull, too small to house his hyperactive brain, exploded, killing everyone around. That was pretty wild. Andrew, 16 years old. His black glasses were his second pair of eyes. Only problem was, they stared back at him. Getting out of being stung, huh? John and Leo again. Leo bored his listeners to death with his talking. The day came when he was the only person left alive on Earth. Yes. This is our giant oak. Do you like trees? How did you do that? You just touched it and the birds went crazy. Don't tell me if you don't want to, but it was weird, okay? Don't do it again. After our walk around the garden, I showed him the cafeteria and the workshop class, and we ended up in the bedroom area. We had an unpleasant encounter there. Let me guess. Aiden and Theo? Says Al. Who else? These are our bedrooms. Oh shit. Here come those two. Aiden says, "Hey, look! It's Mary Shelley with her new girlfriend." "You must be the new guy, right? The star of the moment. Welcome to the Hotel of Fools." We were fortunate, though. Aiden just shook our hands politely and left. "Really?" No, he didn't. "Hey, new guy. Try not to spend too much time with Princess Ellie here, or you'll end up getting AIDS." Theo says, "Hee hee." Well, I hesitate to curse because of the algorithm. Those jerks are Aiden and Theo. I wouldn't get too close if I were you, especially Aiden, or the community guidelines, whatever. I mean, I'm sure the video wouldn't be unlisted, but it might be like, I don't want them to, like, age restrict me or anything. He was involved in a violent hate group and spent some time in jail for beating up an African-American couple. The girl lost an eye. More about Aiden. His father is running for governor. He's the center's biggest benefactor. It's campaign time, so we locked Aiden here to avoid any untimely embarrassment. Pfft, really? More about Theo. The other guy, Theo, is an enigma, but he's scary. When his poor mother tried to escape from her abusive marriage, she was stabbed to death. I wonder if he's making that up. By Theo himself, according to the police, they didn't find enough evidence against him to convict, though. He was 9 years old. Shall we continue? The tour? Alright, vending machine.
Yummy!
What the hell? Yummy. Oh, that does that. I better show him everything before leaving. Let's say at one point he'll say something about one of these cameras. Maybe. Here's the bathroom. Toilets, showers, you know, the usual stuff. I always shower at night when no one's here. It's not allowed, but the caretakers turn a blind eye. Well, our tour ends here. I hope you enjoyed it. What about the class? The room. Tell me, which bedroom were you assigned? Room 9? Come on, I'll show you the way. I've already shown him the bathroom. Better take Oliver to his room. This is Tom's bedroom. This is my bedroom. Logan's. Eric's. Now it's facing the other way. Here it is. I'm in bedroom 3. If you need anything, just... What's that noise? It came from inside.